On Spotlight today is Nigerian pastor turned musician turned actor Jimmy Odukoya as he gets an antagonist role in the new Hollywood project Woman King. Odukoya went from interpreting dramas in Nollywood to a blade-swinging African Willie in the new movie opposite multiple award-winning Viola Davis and British Nigerian actor John Boyega. Details in this next feature. Do enjoy.
First of all, I think that I can't take away from the fact that, you know, Nollywood is my foundation, right? And the good thing about Nollywood is we shoot a lot. And there's always the question of quality versus quantity, which I understand. But the good thing about shooting a lot of times is you become better. Default, because the more you do something, you become better at it. So you have more chances to practice. And what you would find is the more you act, the more comfortable you become as an actor, the more you experience, you explore, and you begin to understand what it is as an actor to hone your craft and what you're bringing to the table. My standard of excellence to myself has always been the same in Nollywood is give 120% wherever you find yourself. Take ownership of your project, whether it means me being costumier. I've been costumier, producer, location manager, script supervisor, generator fixer. I've done everything, because as long as I'm part of it, it is my responsibility for this project to be a success. Because of the rigors in Nollywood, Hollywood is like a cakewalk.
To make up for your shortcomings, I will accept an addition to the tributes. 40 agoje.
Not too old.
And if I refuse?
Then you may no longer use the pot in waiter for your trade.
The pot belongs to the owner.
We have taken control. It belongs to us now.
I'm so surprised you brought your horses here to Plateau.
If they are bitten by the flies, they may get the sleeping sickness.
There is a increasing demand for African stories. Should tell us that we have gold and treasure that we might not have realized we've had the whole time, but people want it, right? To take ownership of our stories, to be intentional about how our stories are told, because whoever tells the story tells from their perspective. Say history is always written by the victors, right? If I'm the one with the money and I'm going to tell a story, I will tell it from my perspective and to whatever goal or motive I'm trying to push or agenda. It's different from we who it is our story. There's a sense of duty and responsibility to authenticity and history. And so it is a challenge to us to take ownership of our stories. And, you know, there's always this thing about why aren't we telling our stories, but even a challenge to us to build the structures that allow us to tell the stories the right way. Me being there and having the opportunity to play a Yoruba man in this role as a Yoruba man myself, I had that sense of responsibility every time I was on set to present us the way that I felt was the right way. Case in point, my character's name originally was Okia Abua, and it was the Oyo General. And I said, ma'am, for sake of authenticity, this cannot work. I was in a conversation with Viola and the director, and Gina said, we can't have this. I said, as a Yoruba man, it will be a great disservice to my people, and my people back home will not forgive me that you as a Nigerian, you were here. And he said this name and you went on with it. So I had them change the character's name to Obade. That's my sense of responsibility and authenticity to my character and to present us the right way.
An evil is coming that threatens our kingdom, our freedom. But we have a weapon. They are not prepared for.
I love Viola Davis. I was a big fan before I met her. I'm a bigger fan now that I know her. And just to say that I know her, like personally, and that we have conversations on the phone is crazy, but I do. And you know, it's a beautiful thing. Her drive, it's so inspiring. She's won it all, but she's still hungry. She still wants to do everything. I was telling another interview that she tore her ACL, and the doctor said she had to do surgery and she wouldn't be able to do the movie. She said, no, she's going to do it. She did every physical stunt. She was in every physical training. she wanted to be the best and give her best performance. I'm like, this is, you have nothing to prove. You've done it all. But for her, it's a thing for herself, you know, the responsibility of telling the story the right way and bringing this character to life was just beautiful to see. So in the movie, I am her arch nemesis. I am the villain of the story. I'm just a spoiler, but no more than that. Go watch the movie to find out the rest. But I had a lot of time with her. So every time, you know, we had fight scenes and things. It was quite regimented. We had many hours of training. We had a schedule when we weren't from my eating. We had a diet plan. So for this movie, I changed my body shape completely. I cut out chicken. I cut out meat. I was just on vegetables for a long time. Then I did vegetables and fish. And that's what I ate all through because I wanted to be lean, because back then they weren't like bulky. So I changed my body completely. We're doing physical training and stunts training hours a day, you know, because we're fighting with different weapons. We're training with swords and different types of weapons. So we had to have it. And what people don't understand is every fight sequence is choreography that you have to remember, and it kept changing because depending on where we were, they'll change it time and time again. And you're fighting with weapons. I mean, doing wrestling one time, my head got bust open. I had to have staples because, I mean, these are weapons that can hurt you. So it's not that we're using form, because you have to understand weight and distribution and knowing how to strike and distance. So there's a lot of things, and how they shoot it, stacking, positioning. So we're fighting and they're putting camera here, so you have to be diagonal. Then you have to remember your fighting and your steps. It was quite a lot. And then I was also a horse rider as well, so horse training, going with the horses and being comfortable around the horses. As a scene I shot where there was fire around, the horse was freaking out, and I'm over there thinking, oh, stay in character, just because this horse was going crazy. I'm bucking, but it helped for what was happening because there was chaos around, there was fire, and you know, he was unsettled, but I had to stay in character. So there was a lot of things that we had to do.